In this fourth clip, we'll talk about Ris Low's resignation from Miss Singapore World. So, Ris, what was your first reaction when you were asked to give up your crown?
Firstly, I was very sad. I feel like the whole world is crashing down on me, and then I come to realize that this might be the best for everybody.
Mm-hmm. So at first, you were in a state of denial. Did you cry?
Yeah. I didn't really cry because it was too much that I can take. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't really... It comes to the point that you don't have any emotions or any reaction to take.
Okay. Mm. Previously, you maintained that, I will not give up the crown.
Mm.
But after that, you changed your decision.
Because I guess it's best for everybody. It's best for the organisers, best for the people of Singapore, best for the members of the public, best for myself as well.
Okay. Did you do it voluntarily or were you asked by ERM to give up your crown?
I did it voluntarily.
So you told the event director, Tracy, that I want to resign.
Mm.
Then what was her reaction?
She was... okay with it. She didn't really say anything, but she was supportive.
Okay. Did she try to ask you to remain in the
Okay. She did.
She tried.
I didn't. I guess it was just enough, lah. Okay. I had given enough people. I had given enough trouble to people, and I don't think that I should continue with it.
Okay. Mm. Okay. Then how do you feel now? Yeah. Okay. Is it a relief?
Yeah, a load off my shoulder. Definitely.
Okay. Can you tell us more about your relationship with the event organizer, ERM?
Actually, I'm quite okay with them.
Mm-hmm.
I guess all the queens are, the five of us, top five.
Are you Tracy Lee's favorite? This is like what people have been talking about, right?
Not really, I guess. No.
Okay, does she have a favorite?
No, she's very... I can say that she's very fair in her work.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Is she kind of like your guardian?
Yes. Okay. She's very nice. She's a very nice lady.
Mm-hmm.
She teaches me how to go, where to go, how to start, and where to move on from where you start.
Okay. So she's been giving you advice all this while. Do you always obey her instructions?
Yes. I guess all the other contestants does as well.
Mm-hmm.
Because she has been rather strict.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. So
if she asks you to do things that you don't want to do, or if she asks you not to do something that you want to do, how would you react?
We can negotiate on these terms as well, actually.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So if you remember, this is the program booklet for Miss Singapore World, and you are the only one with 10 full-page ads, right? 10 full-page spreads on this program booklet. So... actually, who paid for these ads?
These are from outside sponsors and from my parents as well.
So your parents also paid?
Yeah, you have to work hard yourself to find sponsors and find people who are willing to pay for the ads.
Who are some of your sponsors?
Says my parents and my dad's company, my family's friends' companies.
You have to work hard to
get your own sponsors.
Okay. What about the event organizer? Did they try to help you with getting the sponsors?
Yes, of course. Okay. They get the main sponsors, the event sponsors, to sponsor. Like, let's say, if they really do like you a lot, then they would buy a page or two for you.
Okay. Does it mean that you come from quite a well-to-do family because they can pay for 10 full-page ads?
Not really. I would say we are just nice enough to feed ourselves and we don't really splurge on much stuff.
But this shows that your family and your relatives are very supportive of you, right?
Yes.
Okay. So actually, there are some people who think that in effect, by doing so, you are buying your own title. So what do you have to say to this group of people?
Obviously, it's not true because there are some queens out there. In fact, among the top five of us, there are some people who don't even spend a single cent and yet they get a title. It doesn't mean that the more you spend, the more you'll get, or the more you spend, you'll get a title. It doesn't mean that way.
Okay.
And in fact, this would be actually demeaning the judges by saying that because Mm-hmm. The judges have a say in this.
Okay. It's a fair competition.
Yes.
As far as you know, none of the decisions on who is going to be crowned is affected by the number of ads on the program booklet. Okay. All right. So join us again in the next clip where we discuss Ris' relationship with first runner-up, Claire Lee. Gotta get that. Gotta get that. Gotta get that.